The topic of this lecture is development of dictionary and verb adverb combination. Lexicography is a domain of English linguistics in which a lexicon is developed and combined. Lexicon means a dictionary. How does a dictionary work and how do lexicographers compile it? There are certain rules which are used to make a dictionary. Lexicography has two dimensions. One is theoretical lexicography and practical lexicography. This is a scholarly discipline to theorize principles and ways to analyze it. That how are rules formulated to make a dictionary. As Samuel Johnson has propounded some lexicographical rules, and in Urdu dictionary, Shanul Haqqi has also mentioned some lexicographical principles. Practical lexicography is to write dictionary practically. There are different types of dictionaries. ESP, English for specific purpose, and EOP, English for occupational purpose, and under these domains, dictionaries are prepared to fulfill the needs of some specific professions or occupations. Some dictionaries are bilingual. You must have seen English Urdu dictionaries. Some dictionaries are multilingual dictionaries that three or more than three languages have been incorporated in that dictionary. Some are historical dictionaries which cover historical content. Biographical dictionaries, this dictionary is also present in Arabic, that they have categorized biographies of people alphabetically. And Urdu has also compiled Daira Maarif Islam. This is also a large-scale dictionary which also covers biographical elements. Geographical dictionaries, which cover geographical regions or areas. Nowadays, each discipline and subject has its own dictionary because of different registers. Register means different words have different meaning in different settings. As maybe we have discussed earlier, that the word delivery has several meanings. Delivery in cricket commentary has different meaning. Delivery in gynecology has different meanings. Delivery in fast food, free delivery, has different meanings. And in direction or in media studies, delivery of dialogues, it has different meanings. There are different disciplines due to register variations. Now, every discipline has its own dictionary. To explain its terminologies and glossaries, there is dictionary of computer science, dictionary of medical science, dictionary of literature, dictionary of linguistics. Nowadays, there is a mini dictionary in the end of every book. When you find a book, try to see its glossary. Glossaries or terms are also the explanation of those terms which have been mentioned in that book. What is the internal structure of a dictionary? There is a head word or lemma, the word which is being searched. And then there are slashes. And in slash you find pronunciation. Here, Henry Swade's IPA chart keys have been used. International Phonetic Alphabet has been used in Oxford Advanced Learner's Dictionaries. Then there are parts of speech has been mentioned, because a word, when a word changes its part of speech, its meaning also changes. Like fast, if it's adjective, it has different meaning, adverb or verb. So semantics meanings have been mentioned. Meanings are always in simplified form so that the reader can easily understand. Cross-reference is also there, that the same words, picture has been mentioned somewhere else, that word is opposite to it, so cross-reference has also been given. Collocation, which words co-occur. Suppose once upon a time, pay homage, or strong coffee, hot coffee. Etymological or historical notes are also given with some words. Suppose there is Holocaust, they will mention its historical relationship. Images are also given sometimes in the dictionary and sometimes in the end of the dictionary. Introduction of dictionaries. One of the first dictionaries, entitled The Dictionary of Sir Thomas Eliot Knight, was actually a bilingual dictionary, and it was published in 1538. Then there was another dictionary, Dictionary French and English by Claudius Holibern. It was also bilingual dictionary. In 1582, a man named Richard Mulcaster, he wrote the dictionary, The Elementary. It's a spelling guide with undefined words. It shows correct spellings as well as it explains those words which were not defined previously. In fact, dictionaries are also living phenomena. Dictionaries change with the passage of time. Dictionaries add new words or delete the obsolete words. In 1604, Robert Cordray compiled the first authentic English dictionary entitled Table Alphabetical, which contained just 2543 words and their definitions. Cordray is to be credited for inventing the idea that a dictionary should flow from A to Z. Its sequence should be alphabetical. In 1616, English Expositor by John Balokar and English Dictionary by Elisha Coates were also written. In 1656, Glossographia by Thomas Bound was published. It contained 10,000 words, and it discussed their etymologies and historical significance. Then after some time, the new world of English words or a general dictionary was written by Edward Phillips. Phillips boldly plagiarized Blount's work. He copied the meanings of previous dictionaries. In 1755, Samuel Johnson wrote Dictionary of the English Language. We have discussed it in detail. The Oxford English Dictionary, everybody is familiar with it. Oxford Advanced Learner's Dictionary is also its form. Oxford Concise Dictionary. John Simpson, whose picture has been given below, he wrote this Oxford English Dictionary first time. Webster Noah is the founder of dictionary in American scenario, and he is the first person who worked a lot to give a peculiar identity to English dictionary. And 16th October is birthday of Webster Noah, and 16th October is Dictionary Day. Noah Webster, born 1758 and he died in 1843, he wrote a compendious dictionary of the English language in 1806. He learned 26 languages to write this dictionary. He popularized features which would become a hallmark of American English spelling. Center rather than center spelling change were there. Honor, H-O-N-O-R, was written in American English. Program was written P-R-O-G-R-A-M in American English. And he simplified those spellings in American English. He included technical terms from the arts and sciences rather than confining his dictionary to literary verbs. He made it the comprehensive dictionary. He incorporated vocabulary from other domains. Webster was a proponent of English spelling reform for reasons both philological and nationalistic. Corpus linguistics plays its vital role in writing dictionary nowadays. Corpus means collection of digital text. Brigham Young University has the large compilation of corpora. I have given you the link and you can check this link. And there is coronavirus corpus has also been developed. And these corpora have been built by Mark Davies, and he is a professor in Brigham Young University in Utah State, USA. I have a very good interaction with him and he responds my emails. And he told me that how has he worked hard. But for me, the most impressive thing is that he is so much humble that he says, don't write that this is Mark Davies' corpora. Write, give the proper index citation and reference in academic work, but don't give my name that these are Mark Davies' corpora. This is humility and greatness of this person, that he has worked a lot, but even then he does not highlight his name. Okay, I'm writing here electronic lexicography. This book is so good for enabling you that how are dictionaries prepared electronically and digitally. A sketch engine tool, beyond text mining tool, EntConf tool, and there are some other tools which enable you to make a dictionary. Sorry. Frequency examples and emergence of new words and their arrangement are discussed in it. Suppose, when a new word appears frequently in newspapers or in web corpus, they find that this word is emerging and this word should be included in the dictionary. Suppose, word selfie was introduced just a few years ago, and before it selfie word was not present in old dictionaries, but when this word appeared so many times they included in dictionary. Nowadays a new word bothi mean where two persons are in one picture, but in reality they are standing away from each other, so this word will also be included in it. So new words are included. As I have told you earlier that gulubat word was used many times during sit-in of Pakistan Awami Tehreek, and the word guluism, gulunaish, and guluism, these words have been included in Oxford and other English dictionaries. But Urdu dictionaries did not include these words in Urdu dictionary. I'm sorry to say that Urdu dictionaries are static. They don't change with the passage of time. They don't follow new trends. They don't new principles of lexicography. And they are unaware of linguistic changes in Urdu language. While English lexicographers and English publishers like Oxford, Cambridge, Macmillan, Webster and Merriam-Webster and others, they are quite awakening, and they have the sense of the sensitivity of language, and they include new terms and new things in their dictionaries. Okay. Mark Davies also told me that SQL, computer science language, is also used for the understanding of databases. Okay, now without Shanul Haqqi, it would be the incomplete discussion about lexicography. In the right corner, you see Oxford English Urdu Dictionary. This voluminous dictionary was written by Shanul Haqqi, whose picture has been given here. And he was a scholar and a lexicographer, and he wrote Oxford English Urdu Dictionary. But there are some other Urdu dictionaries, Farhang-e-Asfiya. This is a voluminous dictionary, and I have used all of them. And this dictionary has word meanings and masculine, feminine, its usage, different verses in which that particular word has been used. Nasimul Lughat is a small dictionary, Ilmi Lughat, Firozul Lughat. I wish that Muqtadra Qaumi Zubani Urdu Islamabad should be well aware of linguistic changes in Urdu language, and they should incorporate new words in Urdu dictionaries. And the last segment is verb-adverb combination. This is an important characteristic of the modern vocabulary, because there are many expressions which have verb and adverb, like set out, gather up, put off, bring in, made up, of a common verb, of often of one syllable, combining with an adverb. They help us to use and learn collocation. Collocation patterns are very important, and students commit errors in the collocations. Some examples of verb adverb: he drove carefully, they set out a long journey. And adverb is very tricky, because it does not have the fixed placement in the syntactic pattern. There is adverb and verb sequence is also present. He was badly damaged in the accident. Here adverb has been used in the beginning, and verb has been mentioned later. Badly is adverb, and verb is damaged. Thank you so much for your time. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Thank you so much.